Hi, AT from CNC at Home. Atomstack has asked me to review their P7 portable laser engraving machine. It's a nice little machine with a pretty decent diode laser on it. Let's review the specifications. The P7 has a powerful 5.5-watt diode laser with four-fold lens group vertical focus technology that claims a compressed laser dot of 0.02 millimeters. The 5-watt compressed laser spot claims higher focused energy spot than ordinary compressed spots. This would lead to a sharper engraving and cleaner cuts. The P7 comes with four support blocks to increase the height of the machine. This could be helpful when using a roller. The working area is 200 millimeters by 200 millimeters. That is just under 8 inches square. There are several integrated safety features. The two main ones are the horizontal gyroscope and the blue light panoramic glass. The P7's modular design comes 85% pre-assembled and allows for easy replacement, upgrades, and exploration. Full assembly can be completed in 5 minutes. I'll be testing the cutting and engraving ability of the P7 on several types of material: glass, metal, cloth, wood, and more. I will be using light burn for all of my testing. Let's go take a look at the laser and get some burning done. Our first test burn is going to be on 3 millimeter plywood. I'm just going to do a basic circle and see how that works. I'm doing 3 passes, and it turns out that cut through. You can see the blue shining up from underneath the downdraft ventilation, meaning that the laser has cut all the way through. Nice clean cut, relatively quickly. So I can keep track of these settings. I'm going to etch onto the material what I did. I was 400 millimeters per minute at 80% power, 90% power, and that did a good job with 3 passes. Now we're going to try some denim. It's a cotton material, and I did material testing on this, and it didn't turn out the best. If I really wanted to, I could burn something on here. It just ended up, when it got dark, it was really destroying the material. So let's try black acrylic. After some testing, I was able to get some settings, again, 3 passes, and it burns all the way through. Look at this. Here's the first pass, and it's really dark. I have the lights turned off. Second pass, still really dark. It's not getting through. When we get around to that third pass, watch what happens right here. Okay, the laser is getting all the way through now, bouncing off the bottom of my box underneath the filter. So we know that's a good setting. I was able to knock those pieces out very easily. They weren't really stuck, and it has a nice clean cut. A little bit of deformation on the top surface, but the backside looks really good, nice and smooth. Cutting black acrylic with this laser was fantastic. Our next material is going to be a polyester fleece kind of material. And as you can see, it etched down through the fuzzy part, down to the base material. I tried a few different settings to see which worked best. Then I wanted to try cutting through, and I set some parameters, and first just did a little bit of etching on the top, and then cut around all of that and cut a hole. We'll see that here in just a second. So here we're cutting all the way through. Very easy to do with this material. Okay, so the fleece cut through very easily. It really didn't stick at all, so I know I was 100% cut through. And we have our hole here, so I'll just grab that little piece and pull it out. Came out nice and clean. So here's a nice little tag I can use on a Christmas present. Okay. The next material is going to be some shiny steel that I was able to pull out of the recycling bin. It really didn't do a good job. I was doing a crosshatch pattern right onto the material. When it was done, there was nothing. So I covered with a black marker that was provided by Atomstack. And this actually did carve through a little bit, but not the greatest. I'll zoom in here real quick and we can take a look at how that turned out. So it is doable if I spent more time coating that. I tried a few other settings with and without the dark thing. On the right-hand side was 100%, and so that's the best it's going to do. And I don't like running at 100%. The next material is going to be trying the waste board that came with the laser. I believe it's aluminum. It's a non-magnetic material, so I know that for sure. So I'm just getting the height of the laser adjusted. They give you a shim, essentially, you set under the laser, you tighten the head down, and then you're perfectly set. So here I'm not using any darkening or anything like that, doing a crosshatch pattern, and it turned out really well. This was at 1,000 millimeters per minute at 80% power. You can see the crosshatching turned out nicely. So it does a great job on what appears to be an aluminum, not shiny, but a scuffed up aluminum. Now I'm going to try some white acrylic. I tried without any blackening and it barely marred the surface. With the blackening, it barely marred the surface, and really it was doing just some melting. It wasn't cutting through. So a white acrylic, not a good match for this laser. Next, we're going to be doing some leather. I have some giver gloves that I purchased a year or so ago, and trying to figure out what settings were going to work. And here the settings just weren't dark enough. So I'm going to make a second pass. Something happened to the alignment. I don't know what, nothing seemed to get moved unless I bumped the laser head, which, looking at the footage, I didn't. So I'm using a little bit higher power setting and going to make a couple passes, and this turned out really nicely. It's dark enough to read, and hopefully now I'll know which hand this glove goes on. If you're interested in getting some giver gloves, I'm going to put up their URL here, and if you use the code CNC15 at checkout, you'll get a 15% discount on your purchase. I get nothing from that. I just like these gloves. I have a couple pair, and they're really fantastic. Kind of pricey, but I like them. Back to the 3mm plywood, I want to try cutting through and doing a Christmas ornament that I had done on the router last year. And I want to see how it burns with this particular laser. So here it's cut through, and just picking this up, everything's falling right out. So it cut through everything really well. A couple pieces just got kind of wedged in there. They were cut through. Everything came out nice. If you look at some of the finer detail near the middle, it's very thin width-wise, and it turned out nicely. I'll end up taking this out to the garage and put a coat of white paint on it later, and we'll see what that looks like. But it turned out fantastic. Again, a great job. So here's several things that we cut. That we had leather, metal, wood, paper, material, acrylic. In general, the laser did a really good job. I mean, I've been really impressed with it. To get a better look at how the laser's burning, I put the waste board underneath the microscope and zoomed in. As we can see, the lines look really nice. The diagonal lines are the same width, which means the laser dot is approximately square, so that's really good. The hash marks that we see that I've overlaid are 0.5 millimeter apart. And when I did the cross hatch, I told it to do 0.5 millimeter. So the accuracy is really good. I don't think we're getting a burn that's the 0.02 millimeters that was claimed in the literature. It's a solid 0.1 millimeter, if not maybe a little less. Let's talk about the overall performance of this Atomstack P7. To be perfectly transparent, I want to make clear that you know that the P7 was provided by Atomstack for free. They sent it to me to review. That being said, overall, I think it did a really good job. I'd like to go through some pros and cons here of this particular laser and how it's set up. Let's start with the pros. It was easy to assemble. Right out of the box, I got it put together quickly, got it connected up with light burn, and I was burning. So definitely a pro. It has XY limit switches for homing, which is great. I can use light burn to get it home so it's always in the same position. So that's kind of a cool feature. It has a fixed focus lens, and as we've seen with our LE5040, having that fixed focus lens really helps us get a better burn because we're more consistent. It is a small laser physically, so it's easily portable if you need to go somewhere other than your normal shop. It doesn't take up a whole lot of room. It's lightweight and easy to take around, so that's kind of a neat feature. Having the panoramic safety glass minimizes the need to wear the safety goggles all the time. It really captures a large portion of the laser cutting light right within the laser module itself. Let's move on to the cons real quickly. The laser module itself doesn't like to stay in position. It'll slide down just a little bit sometimes. So you need to make sure that you tighten it really well. You don't want that moving down while you're burning because it takes it out of focus and starts bumping into the material. Which is another con, is the clearance underneath that laser module is pretty minimum. It will run into your material unless your material is flat. Working with like the leather as an example wasn't very flat to begin with. Some of the material, if you don't keep it flat, maybe tape it down, the laser is going to bump into that as it's moving and it will move your material around and ruin your burn. So that small amount of clearance is a con in my book, I guess. The wiring that connects the X-axis is also kind of a con because it droops down and can rub across or bump into the material, again, moving it out of position during a burn. I know I said the panoramic safety glass was a pro. It's also a con. The glass itself restricts you from seeing what you're doing. It makes it difficult to align your material and get it positioned correctly so that it's where you want it to be because you can't see. You can't see through the glass. You can't really see underneath the laser module because it's down so close to the material. That being said, overall, this is a sweet little machine for laser engraver and for cutting. It's pretty nice. I'm very impressed with how powerful the emitter is, even though it's a 5-watt laser. Because it's focused so cleanly, it really gives you a lot of concentrated power. I look forward to doing more with the Atomstack P7. I'm going to see if I can get it connected with my rotary roller and do some tubes or pop cans or who knows what with that. And I'm also going to do some glass cutting with it. I know I can do glass cutting with my other laser, so I'm sure this one will be able to etch glass just fine. I'm curious to see how well that turns out. Anyway, I hope you found this video helpful and enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. It really helps the channel out. I will provide a link down in the description for the Atomstack website. You can take a look at their wide range of lasers that they have. Also, if you're interested in getting a pair of giver mittens or giver gloves, I will have the link for that down in the description as well, along as the CNC15 discount code, which will give you 15% off of your purchase. I get nothing for this. I want to make that perfectly clear. Giver is not sponsoring this video in any way. I just like their product. I have a couple pair of gloves, and they were kind enough to provide that discount code that I could pass that along to the members of the channel, or any just viewers of the channel for that matter. Anyway, enjoy doing your CNC at home projects. Oops.